Does this marriage between Microsoft and Nokia make sense to you?
I don't really think so, because from Microsoft's perspective, Nokia's already using Windows. It's unclear what additionals did they get from this deal. I think, you know, they're buying the handset operating company. That's what they're buying. They're not buying the patents. So I don't really think they're getting much. From Microsoft's perspective, they want to develop a competitive ecosystem to compete with Android, Google's Android, and Apple's iOS. And Nokia was already using Windows, so it's unclear what additional benefit Microsoft really gets from this.
And they are spending a lot of money, $7 billion for this. So if it doesn't make sense to you, I'm wondering if there's something else that perhaps we don't know about. I mean, you mentioned the patents. They have access to for 10 years to their patents. I mean, is there something in those Nokia patents that they could use that will really put them ahead in the smartphones race?
Well, it can help them in future potential litigation with Apple, Google, or any other player. That's for sure. But I think the more interesting thing really is Microsoft is making a move to vertically integrate. They're going the way of Google, potentially, with Google purchase of Motorola Mobility, and the way of Apple, with Apple's really the completely vertically integrated model in terms of the hardware and software, and they think that is a benefit, having both the hardware and the software internally. You saw they already made some attempts in hardware before with the Xbox, the Zune, and more recently with the Surface.
These were not big successes,
not
so
big
they
successes.
Needed some sort of boost or some sort of help. I want to ask you what impact this will have on the low-end smartphone market. Does it take Nokia out of the game?
Yeah, that's the interesting one, because Nokia really had two main platforms. They had Windows for the high-end, and they had this Acer platform they were using for the low-end of the market. And so it's possible. We don't know, because we don't know exactly what the strategy will be of Microsoft, but it's possible they may de-emphasize or even shut down Acer. It's very possible. And that's actually good for the rest of the low-end players, which is Samsung, because Samsung is actually very strong in both the high end and the low end, and the Chinese, such as Lenovo, Coolpad, ZTE, Huawei. So I think it could be potentially very beneficial for those players if Microsoft does de-emphasize the low end platform.
Now, as a result of this big deal, Stephen Elop, who was the CEO of Nokia, on Monday stepped down as CEO, and now he's going to be the head of devices at Microsoft. We do know that Steve Ballmer is going to be leaving as the CEO of Microsoft. There is some speculation that Stephen Elop might succeed him. Do you think he has the right DNA to lead Microsoft and to create a new vision for Microsoft?
Yeah, it's not really clear to me. I mean, I think obviously that decision is for the board of Microsoft. From my perspective, you know, I look at Microsoft, I think they're very good at the enterprise side, and they've tried many times on the consumer side and failed. And so I think the movement to use someone like Steve Elop, focus more on devices, is probably not a good strategy. And so I would beg to differ with that.